To receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take you to himself, may the angels lead you to the Most High.
To receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, for Father Fernando, glory and perpetual light shine upon him.
To receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Greetings of peace in the risen Lord. This is to express my deepest condolence to you and to the Babanis community of the Philippines on the occasion of the departure from this world toward heaven of Father Fernando Fietta. I would like to express condolences also on behalf of St. Anthony of Padua Parish in Milan. During last week, we have been praying for the eternal rest of our soul, together with the people of God in this community. And the Gabanis fathers working in this parish, Father Octavio, Father Jao, and Father Julio. Father Fernando has been the first Gabanis father in senior Philippines more than 50 years ago, who was very committed to his apostolate and and you have been grateful for all the efforts he has done in order to plant our Christian in this country. We pray that the good Lord may grant him eternal rest and peace in his kingdom. May the Lord strengthen our faith in his resurrection and give us his consolation. Be assured of our prayers. Now I read to you the letter of Father Fierro. Greetings, O Father Fernando. In my personal name of the brother and sisters of Father Fernando and the relatives, I would like to give my Christian heartfelt greeting to my dear cousin and religious brother on the day of this day. With Christian faith, I want to give glory to God for the life, death, and resurrection of their Father Fernando. I entrust him to the mercy of God, so that I may welcome him into his kingdom of life and peace, and reward him for the good he has shown in the earth. I want to thank you too, dear Father Fernando, who motivated and encouraged my vocation to follow you like a madness. I have always admired you for your lively intelligence, your creativity, and your generous dedication to the cause of education. Thank you for having accepted to go as a missionary to the Philippines, giving you space and new vitality to the Evangelist person. You give your life for a return to our school, which became your new family. I truly believe in the sharing and cultural work between religious and lay people, and you promoted their involvement in an education project. Deeply convinced that the school should constitute an environment for an original and authentic educational service. This is why you have chosen male and female collaborators capable of building communities of regenerating the education to educate, who care for the present and the future of young people. You knew how to inspire affection in children and esteem in the teachers to help they were called and involved in a collaborative project as an equal. The competence and cultural depths of his father, Fernando, his concern for the life of the school, his passion for young people were a guarantee. They were conquered by his sincere enthusiasm, his openness to dialogue, trust, and great disposition to friendship. You have chosen the Philippines as your homeland. You have appreciated the culture. You have loved everyone who has met you, and you have felt love. You wanted to stay with the world. Rest in peace, Father Fernando. May you be like the grain of wheat that falls to the ground, produces much fruit. You have always sought the kingdom of God. And now you know the whole truth, because you are in God's love, we are ready. Remember us and obtain from the Lord Holy Gavani's vocation, that we are dedicated to the education of young people. We greet you and keep you in mind and heart. Dina, Giancarlo, Marisa, Lorenza, and Piero. And the many colleagues and friends from Italy who were unable to attend your funeral. I also take this opportunity to thank the bishop, the priest, the Gavani's brothers, the young people, and the friends and traveling companions of Father Fernando for all you have done for him. The Lord reward you. From Father Fietta. Now we read to you the message of our beloved Church Superior Father Fernando. Our dear Father Fernando Fietta, concluding his mission on this earth and in the final act of obedience to God, he gave his spirit into the hands of the Father. Certainly, with the same confidence as the Christ Jesus on the cross, who was the model of his chains, poor and obedient life, as enshrined in the congregation of scholars of charity, in his book of Evangelists. Father Fernando was one of the first Evangelists to begin the mission of the Philippine Evangelists. promises are that he in life and time have ever read in the living lands. This was confirmed to me on the visit I made to the delegation in December 2019, when he could manifest himself only through the signs of the face hidden by promises. I personally had few opportunities to live with Father Fernando. Our meeting took place in the Assemblies in Rome, starting in 2008. But he always manifested that enthusiasm in defending his collection, in sharing and participating in the discussion on his basis prayer for the coming of the kingdom of heaven and prepared himself for me. He worked hard in the field of education. Those who had the opportunity to work more closely with him found was a full-time educator, showing his vocation with true fatherly love, as Venerable Father Anthony and Marcos Cavalis did and asked their children. May each one keep the good teaching example left by Father Fernando. He loved this land, adapted it, and was adopted. He was not afraid to mourn to deeper waters in response to the Divine Master's invitation. He preserved to the end and kept his faith and his vocation as a religious and priest. May the God of mercy and kindness receive you in his kingdom. I would also like to leave a brief word to the informative community of the Bongo and to all the health professionals who have been with him throughout these many months, helping him to carry his cross with all patience and charity. May this source of advancement and mission be translated into vocational fruitfulness and the most necessary blessings for your families. Father Fernando, thank you for example of fidelity and dedication, and that from heaven you continue to work for the educational action of youth through your intercession with God. May our dear Mother Mary welcome you in her arms and introduce you to her son. May you receive the beautiful reward of being a zealous son of our venerable founders. Shine like a star in the sky, because you taught righteousness to me. Rest in peace. Rome,
thank you. Thank you.